almost entirely as a politician.
As a politician? He was never a Mahatma, and I refuse to call him Mahatma. I've never in my life called him Mahatma. He doesn't deserve that title. Not even from the point of view of his morality. You see?
Going back to the Pune Pact, the Yoravda Pact.
Yes.
Can you remember a little of what Gandhi said to you and what you said to him?
Oh, I know it very well. I know it very well. The British government had, in the original award which MacDonald had given, had accepted my suggestion. I said, look here, the Hindus want that there should be a common electorate, so that there will be no separatist feeling between the scheduled caste and the Hindus. We think that if you have a common electorate, we would be submerged. And the nominees of the scheduled caste who would be elected would be really slaves of the Hindus, not independent people. Now, I told Mr. Ramsay MacDonald that this is a sort of a thing that he might do. Give us a separate electorate. Give us a separate electorate, and also give us a second vote in the general election, so that Gandhi cannot say that we are separated in point of election. First of all, my contention was this, that for 5 years we live separately from the Hindus, with no kind of intercourse or intercommunication, you see, of a social or a spiritual sort. What can one day's cycle of participation in a common electorate do to remove this hardened crust of separatism which has grown for centuries? It's a foolish thing to think that if two people vote together, you see, in a common polling booth, that their hearts are going to change. It's nothing of the kind. Mr. Gandhi has got this madness in him. Well, let this be satisfied by this kind of a system. Give the untouchables 2 votes and give them a population representation of ratio, so that the weightage would be in terms of votes and not in terms of representatives, so that the Gandhi and others may not complain. That Ramsay MacDonald accepted. The award was really my suggestion. I wrote to him a letter from Naples that this is what I would like him to do, you see, so that there may be no trouble. This is exactly what he did, you see, gave us a separate electorate and also a vote in the general electorate. But Gandhi didn't want that we should send our 2 representatives. Therefore, he didn't want the separate electorate part of the award, and went on fast. Then they all came to me. They said, well, the British government said, if he agrees to abandon the award, then we have no objection. But we can't abandon the award ourselves. We have given the award. We have taken all things into consideration. We think this is the basis. You have to read Ramsay MacDonald's letter. It's a very clear statement that we haven't done anything to aggravate the separation. In fact, we are trying to bridge it up by bringing the 2 sections together in a common electoral roll. But Gandhi's object was that we should not get the free independent representative. Therefore, in the first place, he said, no representation ought to be given to us. That's how he stand in the round table conference. He said, I recognize only 3 communities. Namely, Hindus, Muslims and Sikhs. These are the only 3 communities that will have a political recognition in the constitution. But the Christians or the Anglo-Indians or the scheduled caste will have no place in the constitution. They must merge themselves in the general community. That was the stand that he had taken. Well, all his friends, I know, you see, were asking him how foolish was his attitude. His own friends had quarreled with him on this subject. That if you are prepared to give a special representation to the Sikhs and special representation to the Muslims, who are 1,000 times superior in strength and political and economic stamina, how can you deny it to the scheduled caste or to the Christians? He always used to say, oh, you don't understand our problem. That's all he was saying. Alexander even, who was a great friend of his, had a serious quarrel with him, as he told me. Then that French woman, who was his disciple, I forget her name now, she also had a great quarrel with him. That we don't understand this attitude. Either you say, we won't give anything to anybody. Let there be just a common role. Then we can understand that. That's a democratic thing. Go on saying that you will give it to the Muslims and you give it to the Sikhs, but not to the scheduled caste, seems absurd. He could give no answer. So we suggested this method. He also didn't, in the beginning, when he wrote a letter, Ramji Mahesh, he said, no, the scheduled caste should have nothing. No representation. Then his own friend said to him, this was asking for too much. You see, nobody would support you in this matter. Then Malviya and others came to me and said, well, could you not help us to solve this problem? You see, I said, well, I don't want to solve this problem by sacrificing what we have been able to get from the British Premier.
So you went to Pune?
I suggested the alternative formula. And that formula was that I am not prepared to give up the separate electorate, but I am prepared, you see, to modify the thing. In this way, namely, that the candidates who would stand in the final election on behalf of the scheduled caste should be first elected by the scheduled caste themselves, sort of a primary election, and that they should elect four people. Four. And the four then should stand in the general elected. And let the best one come. See, so that we get some assurance that you don't put up your own nominees, but that we do get people who will express our voice in the parliament. That Mr. Gandhi had to accept. So he accepted that. Of course, we had the benefit of it only in one election, in 1937. There you will see that the Federation swept the poll. Gandhi was not able to get a single candidate of his party elected.
Well, did he bargain very hard at the end of his fast?
Oh, of course. He bargained and bargained. I said, nothing doing. I am prepared to save your life, provided you do not make hard terms. But I am not going to save your life at the cost of the life of my people. This is too much. How much I have labored, see, in all this, I know very well. And I am not going to sacrifice your whim. Sacrifice our people's interest just for the sake of satisfying yours is a whim. How can one day's common election alter the situation? Simply cannot alter the situation.
He worked entirely as a politician.
He was never a Mahatma, and I refuse to call him Mahatma. I've never in my life called him Mahatma. He doesn't deserve that title. Not even from the point of view of his morality. You see?